I'm Jonathan Ebba with UNH Extension. We're here at the Bakey Farm Initiative, and we're going to do a series of videos on how to construct and install a greenhouse or high tunnel. So we're going to construct a Rimmel greenhouse systems 30 foot by 96 foot nor'easter unheated high tunnel. So we're going to do a single layer of poly, and you can see there's already production in the ground going on here, and we are going to work around some of this production. Some of the techniques we do are specific to this house. Please, of course, follow your greenhouse manufacturer's instructions, as some manufacturers might have different systems and different attachments. Before you purchase a greenhouse or a high tunnel, it's important to know what you're going to use it for and if you even need it. Remember, these structures are just tools. Don't buy a tool until you know that it'll help you do what you need to do more efficiently and more profitably. Greenhouses, they're typically heated with production in pots, either on the bench or on ground fabric. Whereas a high tunnel can be heated or not. It utilizes in-ground production, which requires irrigation. An unheated high tunnel can extend the growing season or produce crops in season faster. We're going to work on a freestanding hoop house. That structure can be used for either application. Gutter-connected greenhouses are beyond the scope of these construction videos. When selecting the location for your house, choose a level area with good drainage and sun exposure. If the site is not level, some site work is acceptable to get it more level. But keep in mind, if this house will have in-ground production, you might not be able to change the soil depth very much. Consider wind exposure at the site. In high wind areas, the greenhouse manufacturer might add additional safeguards, like longer ground posts or additional wind bracing. The house that we'll be constructing has wind bracing both at the base and the ridge due to winds at this site. Consider which utilities, water, electricity, fuel, etc., will be needed at the house and make sure that you're able to provide those at the location. The greenhouse or tunnel should be 12 feet from other structures. This helps prevent shading, but also gives room for snow removal. Select a site that's not shaded by trees or other structures during the time of year that the house is going to have crops. You can determine which potential obstructions will cast shade on the location at all times of the year by creating a sun chart. This is a process you can do anytime, and it only takes about an hour. See the link in the description to a fact sheet to learn how to make a sun chart. One interesting consideration for location is actually what's called dark quality. If you'll be growing crops that require short days, like chrysanthemum, poinsettias, or short day onions, for example, the location needs to be free from street lamps, traffic, or other sources of artificial light after sundown. Legal implications and requirements of constructing or owning a tunnel or greenhouse on your farm are going to vary by state and municipality. Be sure to check with your local authorities. Some municipalities will require a building permit for construction. Others may not. The type of structure we'll construct in these videos is exempt from property tax in some towns when it's used for agriculture. This may or may not be true in your town or state. The local building inspector may have requirements for load design for these structures. Be sure to find this out beforehand and discuss requirements with the manufacturer of your greenhouse or tunnel. The manufacturer of your greenhouse or high tunnel wants you to succeed. Work with them to select the size, type, and features that make sense for your farm or business. Grants might exist to offset the purchase cost of the greenhouse or tunnel. Check with your local cooperative extension, USDA service center, or farm bureau. Sometimes a farm or greenhouse range will offer a used structure for sale. If you're considering buying a used house, be sure to weigh all of the associated costs. Very likely you'll need to purchase new ground posts, new hardware, and new attachment systems. The labor required to disassemble a greenhouse or a tunnel might be greater than the labor required to assemble it, and transportation can be costly. Pulling old ground posts from the ground can be difficult and dangerous. In the long run, it might be cheaper and simpler to just buy a new house. Before doing any site work, be sure to contact DigSafe to mark any underground utilities. The site should be level as possible. If you're going to do site work, use a transit or a site level. The maximum pitch in either direction should be about 3/4 of an inch per 12 foot. For high tunnels in a field, since you're going to be growing in that soil, you want to avoid too much soil disturbance. A site that's naturally level or slightly crowned is best. Level out any low spots. You'll see in the house that we're going to construct, the field slopes a little bit toward the front of that house. For a greenhouse, the site can be leveled, backfilled, and compacted if necessary. Be sure to level the area beyond the perimeter of the house. For greenhouses, the site should also be slightly crowned for drainage. Consider your surface material. If the greenhouse is going to have ground fabric which is walked on, the underlying surface should have a layer of stone dust to prevent rocks from tearing through the fabric. Before construction, be sure that the site is cleared of all roots and vegetation.
The first thing I wanted to talk about was the orientation of the greenhouse here. And so as the sun kind of rises in the east, moves through the south in this hemisphere and sets in the west, we want the length of the greenhouse to be able to receive that motion of the sun. And so we orient the length of the greenhouse, that ridge pole, from east to west, so that the long face is able to see the sun as it moves across.